homeless roam the streets, where broken glass and broken dreams are shattered and scattered amongst debris. Separation or rot, and still they laugh and dream of a mansion above the half. No one to speak up on their behalf. Now tell me, do they stand a chance?
My name is Amir Howie, and I'm a struggling artist from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, and I am homeless. And I feel as though that the situation for the homeless is a very terrible situation, especially with the World Trade Center, and it's very hard to get a job out here. Never ask, when will they make a change? When it rains, normally what I try to do is
go to the club and hang out till about 5 o'clock,
yeah,
and then
four or five in the morning, and then I'll come in after that.
Cause the club is free. So
yeah, cause the club is free. So then we'll be able to get out the rain, right? And then we'll just go to the club and we'll hang out there till like 3 or 4 in the morning. And then when we come back, we'll go into the garage or either down in the train station until the wee hours of the morning. And then we're woken up, things of that nature. This is an everyday process of being homeless.
Hi, my name is Farrell. I'm from New Jersey, and I'm a homeless guy, too. You know? I know that, you know, like, there's different reasons for people that be on the streets. My specific reason is, you know, like, I was in jail, you know, I was a jail person, you know. And there's a difference, like, when people come home from jail, most likely they go home to either their individual selves or their family. So I came home to my individual self because I don't have family. What I call my family is, you know, relatives. You know what I mean? They're relatives to me. They're not family. A family is a person, in my opinion, that is concerned about you and your welfare. You know what I mean? Making sure that you're right. I don't have a person that has my back to be concerned about me and my welfare. So since I've been 14, this has been all Farrell. You know what I mean? I've been taking care of myself every day of my life since then. I mean, and it's a lot of different reasons why I think I'm very educated. I have a college education. I have a high school diploma, too. I'm finishing school. I go back and I start school again in 19. I go to college for culinary, you know what I mean? So I have to be able to maneuver in and out of life, being able to wake up on time, being able to get to work and everything. You know, I do all these things, but in the meantime, I just don't have a place to stay. They super tight
on
me.
They're supposed to be. They
no, they not.
I used to have a pair of them.
Not like built made like this.
Yeah, I used to.
Your legs ain't going. Look, your legs is not getting. Your legs is too big for that. Look at that hole. Come on, you're not fitting in there.
I used to wear them.
I know, but this don't stretch.
Ew, man, that dog stink. During the daytime, I go to a program from 7 o'clock in the morning until 1 o'clock in the afternoon. There I eat breakfast and I see my counselors and I get my business taken care of. After that, I go to the park and I come back and either I'll draw or I'll go to Barnes & Noble and I'll read or I'll hang with my brother, Farrell. And we do constructive things during the daytime. He keeps me up on point with things that I need to do. He's a real true friend. And he tells me things I don't want to hear even when I don't.
All right, well, I'm going to tell you this. You really good. I really don't like you. Well, I consider this young man right here my family. This man right here is, you know, like me and him are brothers, you know. Whatever he does, I'm there for him. And he has my back at everything, and I have his back at everything. You know, I do a lot of thinking. I'm a constant thinker, you know what I mean? So I try to stay on him to be the same way. You know, he's an artist. You know, he draws. I'm an artist. I write. You know what I mean? That's what I'm here for. I'm writing a book. I'm writing a book on homelessness, just like you're right. You're taking your thing. I'm writing a book on it. And I have my diaries. You know, I have 3 of them. And I constantly fill them too. I'm hoping to get published.
My name is Brooklyn Mike. You know what I'm saying? Part of the Union Square crew here. I've been on the street for now, what, I guess about the better part of half a year now, you know, but I, on and off, you know, I've been on the street for like, I don't know, I guess like a good year or two, you know, total.
I've been on the street for 3 months, me myself, but there's the guys I know that have been out here for 12 years, 10 years, and they travel all through the U.S., they chase what homeless people call, they chase the heat. You know what I mean by chase the heat? They go to the happening cities and they chase the heat. Say, like, now it's winter in in New York. So it's going to get very cold here. So they'll leave and they'll go to California and Texas and Florida because it's going to be warmer for the winter. You know what I mean? It's not, the winter won't be so hard on them. To me, in my opinion, they're hiding from reality. I mean, these guys, they wake up in the day, they find out what their hustle's going to be all day. They don't even consider going to fill out an application. I mean, this is not part of their everyday routine. They're not trying to get off the street. They're liking it. You know what I mean? We have a saying amongst us, there's a difference between being homeless and hopeless. Some people are hopeless. You know what I mean? Because they are content with what they're doing. You know what I mean? They don't want nothing else out of life. They are happy with what they're doing. But then you have guys like I strive to make a better for myself. You know what I mean? I want a family. I want to picket fence, 2.1 kids. I want these things. I'm still a young man. You know what I mean? I just seen a deaf person with a cell phone.
That's great.
That's funny.
Yo.
What are you going to do? What are you going to do? Holler to the phone?
So what puts you on the streets?
You know, a lot of different things. Oh, I'm sorry. Sorry about that.
Precious cargo.
You know, drugs, no job, you know, things like that. Things of that nature. That's Sir Wheels.
And Sean Penn right here.
Oh, what?
Sean Penn.
I'm an actor. I want to be an actor on Broadway.
I'm going to be an actor someday, you know, because I believe that I would fit nicely in, you know, the movie awards. You know, I think I would do nice. You know, I have a... I wrote out what I'm going to say when I get my award.
Right on. That's real. That's real.
Thank you for all my fans and all the people that go to movies, pay like, you know, three times too much to go see like a half-assed movie, you know, with people that can't act.
No,
you know what I'm saying?
Studying the Actors Guild just for the simple fact.
Are you in SAG?
Yes. Yeah. Just for the simple fact that, you know, the entertainment industry is so involved with nothing. You know, the...
What, that they like...
The business industry.
The devil,
right?
The devil's behind that.
Must, no.
It must be.
No, really?
Yes.
No.
Yes, Wheels.
Vietnam War. I 2.5 years. I was a sergeant. I got shot. They brought me back. I went to California after that. I continued my career in the Marine Corps, and I was a drill sergeant in Camp Pelly. I've been on the street about 2.5 months. What put me on the street is I lost my job, and in the World Trade Center shit, my union, that the union I was in, they just dropped dead because the union was in World Trade Center. One. So, you know, I lost my job, I lost my apartment and everything, but kind of like it out here now, you know what I'm saying? I kind of like it here.
That was cool. That was real cool.